Okay, so there's probably more things I can find in this first area here, the Forgotten Crossroads. I'm sure there's a few things that I've missed, but I think I've cleared out the place pretty well. So let's go on to the new area that I found last time, the Green Path. It'll be nice to have a change in environs. I just hope the pool of boiling water isn't too omnipresent of a feature. I don't remember if I've mentioned it here, but I am not a fan of instant death pits or anything that sends you back to the start. These ones are a bit lenient since they do that, they send you back to the start rather than just instantly murdering you. But that's still a little bit bothersome to me. Ooh, a lot of enemies camouflaged here as bushes. I'm going to have to pay especially close attention to the environment. Oh! Okay. So those dudes explode on death, so don't approach their corpses. Gotcha. Let's see, what happens if I take these dudes out in melee? Well, that one didn't explode. Maybe it's just the larger ones? Mistimed that. Maybe that was a separate. Oh no, there it is, yep. There he is exploding, so yeah. The big ones explode when you kill them like that, so watch out for that. I like this area so far. Whoops. Pfft. Yeah, that's my issue with that sort of thing. But yeah, I like this area so far. All of the vegetation just makes it feel a lot more, well, lively. Of course, that's not always a good thing, what with these traps here. So this area seems to be fairly trap-centric, with all of these various monsters. Oh, I thought I killed you. Shit. I'm doing really poorly here. With all these monsters, camouflaging themselves in the environment. Yeah, let's heal up before I croak. I'll probably be taking plenty more damage from tricks like that before things are done. Every time I see something wiggling, I can't help but feel that it's something that's going to attack me. Which also does a very good job of conveying that there's actual life here. In the other cavernous area, like, there were other bugs around, but for the most part it was fairly lifeless, so aside from the stray stalactite, you didn't really have to pay too much attention to the environment. Here, where life is flush, you have to pay close attention, because there are plenty of things competing for survival here. The hell's the point of this little nook here? Okay, there's a little money thing. Couldn't quite tell that at first, because it was covered in the vegetation. Would really like some more easy-to-beat enemies to come up. Ooh, a bench, that works. Just something that gives me the ability to restore my health. This is actually even better because. Oh, okay, so I have to purchase the map from Cornifer if I want to be able to fill it in. Okay. That makes sense. Alright, so I'm gonna have to make locating him my primary objective here. Not that I have any idea where he is, so I'm not really sure that's something I can, focus on. I'll just happen across them when I do. Hello, are you also an enemy? Perhaps not. You chose to retreat rather than to fight. A possible ally, perchance, who I don't think I can reach as of yet. Yeah, that is. Oop. That is not a pixel-perfect jump. I am just like a single pixel away from actually being able to land that, so I'll definitely need some sort of upgrade if I want to come from this way. Unless I can lead an enemy over here, which could be possible. If there's a flying one. Hey, there you go. Ooh, these ones have a new attack available to them. By which I mean an attack, since the previous ones just kind of floated on after you. This is gonna be tough to position him correctly. Especially what with him dashing over the place like that. Oh, this is perfect. Alright, let's see if she's an ally or an enemy, assuming she didn't flee even further in. Which looks like it might be the case. I'm just gonna Hadouken you to death, but my accuracy with that is pretty piss poor. I need to work on that. But already, this area is a noticeable step up in difficulty compared to the previous one. Oh. These guys, however, not so much difficult, just kind of annoying to deal with. Well, with how they rocket all over the place. Let's see, I can continue onward. I wonder if ooh, hello! No. Well, that did not hurt me nearly as much as I thought it would. Woo. Is that guy gonna come up again if I go to 1 HP? Yes, he is. Nope. So how does that work? Oh, here it comes again. Wow, that happens so quickly. I really don't have time to get away, do I? Ah, but all it takes is a single Hadouken. And he's down. Oh, okay. So a single attack and he, his leaf covering is destroyed. Oh, I see what I need to do here. And then I can attack him. Yep. Okay, this isn't so bad. Ugh, the little bug is so fast, but turns out he can't stand boiling water either. Boiling water. Ugh. I really dislike not having a map. Come on, Cornifer. Where are you, buddy? I don't know why I thought that would be a good idea. Whoa, speaking of poor frame rates, jeez. Probably because of all the various environmental effects going on. Honestly, it doesn't actually affect my ability to play all that much, so it's not a huge deal. I'm just kind of a little bit of a stickler for frame rates, especially in games like this. Maybe if I turned off VSync, that might help matters. I loathe screen tearing, but sometimes it's not that bad with 2D games. Kind of varies from game to game, really. So I'll see how I feel about this. Honestly, it doesn't seem to have helped performance-wise in this area here. So with this as a litmus test, I'm going to say that disabling the VSync, not exactly all that helpful. Alright, I'll just have to deal with the slightly poor frame rate. It's probably in partly because of the fact that I'm both streaming and recording this at the same time. That's pretty intensive. A bit too much for my hardware to handle with without much effort. Okay, there it absolutely affected my ability to play because I tried jumping but I failed because of the frame rate. I wasn't able to have the proper reaction time. Well, if it ends up affecting it in a more dire situation, then maybe I'll have to do something. But for now, it seems fine. I haven't been paying too much attention to the pathways that I've been able to take, but I think there was some stuff back here that I could check out. Treasure! Trove and another trap plant. God damn it. These guys suck ass. Oh, hey there, EC. How you doing? Have you played any of this game, Hollow Knight, before? It's pretty damn good if you like 2D Metroidvanias. Fucking gorgeous, for one thing. Mechanics are nice, and it's pretty damn fun to play. Ugh, again, no map. Yeah, I definitely recommend picking it up if this is the kind of game that interests you. I think it might be available on PS4 as well as PC, I'm not really sure. Ooh, nice, 2 for 1. 2 bugs with 1 magic bullet. You know that old saying, right? Up or down? Well, down is generally progress since I'm heading deeper into the underground, so let's see where up takes me. Are you a friend or a foe? Oh, you're not even alive. Oh, nope, there we go. I came from the wrong side, I guess. Mini boss time! This is a bigger version of shield and sword bug knights I came across earlier. Hadoukens, ooh, seems pretty effective. Wonder if I can, I can break those. I can't reflect them back, unfortunately. They're not too dangerous, though. Unlike a previous enemy that did that, they don't actually spawn creatures. It's just a leaf ball that then explodes, but I'm about to die here, so that's not a good sign. Oh dear. I might actually die here to a mini-boss of all things. Ugh. And he has a combo, of course. Well, should be able to hit it with a Hadouken though. Alright, easy enough. I kinda don't like feel like fighting that boss immediately, especially since there's probably another bench somewhere nearby that I just missed that would make the boss run a lot easier. The greater mind once dreamed of leaf and cast these caverns so. In every bush and every vine, the mind of Urn reveals itself to us. Well, okay then. Do you hear that cry in the background? That's the sound of a little grub friend who I'd really like to rescue, but I don't think I can actually continue from this way. Without enemies to bounce off of, I just don't have the ability to get up there, so sorry, friendo, I'll have to help you at a later date. So I could try heading further down. There might be a bench down this way. That's what I'll hope for. That's the way I came in. Oh wait, this guy's dead. I was wondering why my attacks weren't hitting him. Oh-ho, what is this? A toll machine. Aha, here's the bench I was looking for. Do I go fight the boss now or do I continue to explore? I think I'd rather fight that mini boss first. What is it with enemies that shoot diagonal bullet patterns? That always seems to screw me up. I just have a hard time tracking their shots effectively. Alright, round 2 with the Nightfellow. Right, he has a 2-hit combo if I stay close. I'm not sure how I'm supposed to get in quickly enough to actually damage him before his guard gets up. I guess when he starts doing that, that's when I can bounce. Oh. Well, that was easier than I thought. So that wasn't even really a mini boss. That was probably just a larger regular enemy that I'm going to be seeing more often from now on. So I'll definitely have to get better at fighting him if I want to have a good chance of surviving. Oh, well, that's an immediate environment change. It actually looks like I'm back in the first area, but this is still clearly part of the new one since it's not marked on my map at all. Well, I don't have a map is what I mean. Maybe Cornifer will be around here. I don't think that's Cornifer, but there is someone around here making rather unusual noises. It sounds like they're further up. That just leads back down into the lush jungle. Oh. Well, you two look like you're having a fun time. Oh, mistimed my pogo bounce. Ooh. What? Okay, I thought I timed that correctly. God damn it. Oh, he can summon children. Oh god, I might die here as well. Yeah, I guess the game is getting more difficult at this point. Well, I am getting more soul, which means I can heal if I can find the time to do that, of course. Okay, whew, that was close. I'm off of death's door at least. Yeah, fuck you too, buddy. Hello there. You have a very grumpy face. Not that I blame you, given you were just being snacked on. Just what do you think you're doing? You dare to come between me and my prey? Is it a habit of yours to scurry about, getting in the way and causing bother? Know this, cur. I am Zote the Mighty, a knight of great renown. Cross me again, and you'll find out why they call my weapon Life Ender. Okay then, buddy. Whatever you say.
You know, me a beast.
What are you still bothering me for? I'm a knight. I'm not interested in your childish games. I need my rest. Begone, lest I draw my nail.
You know, me a beast.
Alright, I guess I'll be coming across him sometime later. Let's see what else is over here. No music at all. Ominous. Oh, god damn it. Actually, if I recall, can't I just bounce off of spikes? Yep, I can do that repeatedly, like I'm Scrooge McDuck. I gotta get the timing down though. I'm still having a huge amount of trouble with that. Oh, what did I think of the Ring City DLC? I thought it... Ooh, stalactites. I thought it was pretty good. Definitely had some design issues. The angels were a bit annoying to deal with. Although apparently they have, in the latest patch, nerfed them. And they're apparently, like, a complete non-threat now, which is, kind of a bit of an over-nerf, I feel like. Well, they were kind of annoying to deal with. I feel like making them just completely pathetic is not the way to go about balancing them. But yeah, I didn't like the angels, or especially the Judicator that kept summoning those Flame Knights. Ugh, that was a huge pain in the ass, but overall I liked it a fair bit. I thought the areas looked cool, the level design was decent, the weapons were amazing. And the boss fights were fun, except for Midia. Ugh, that one was awful. You sort of hated it? What did you dislike about it? Hold on, can I not get over there? That might not be possible at the moment, because I don't really have the ability to gain height here. I'm gonna head out of the room and head back. Smaller enemies respawn upon room reset. And I can't recall if I killed any flies. If I can drag a fly over there, I should be able to bounce my way over. Otherwise, it might just be inaccessible for now. Yeah, the Judicators were friggin' awful. Ugh. Let's see, you're a ground crawling grub. Yeah, nope. God damn it. No flies. I guess that area is just verboten to me at the moment. Then what the hell is the purpose of coming here? There must be some sort of movement upgrade I'll be able to unlock at some point. Either that or a mechanic I'm missing. It took me a long while to figure out that I could bounce off of enemies if I... enemies and spikes if I struck off of them like that. Oh, it sounds sequence break-tastic. What is the sequence break you need to perform there, may I ask? Because off the top of my head, I just can't think of anything I could do there. I'm probably not going to bother with it since I'm already heading away from it, but I'm just curious. Your complaints with the DLC would be level design and encounters that force you to rush through the level. Bosses with way too much HP and a complete non-ending after beating Gale. Yeah, I didn't like that complete non-ending. Like, some people have argued that it kind of fits Dark Souls, but I disagree. Like, I don't think there needs to be any bombastic cutscenes to end things off, but something. Like, even just when you bring the blood of the Dark Soul to the painting girl, like just a cutscene of her finishing her painting or something, or making more progress or whatever, like that would have been nice, and then maybe have a credits roll after. But as it is, it just kind of ends and it's a bit of a wet fart. Oh, I can't actually sequence break there. Oh, never mind then. I was fine with the boss's HP. Except for Midia again, that boss is just a huge pain in the ass. I could have just hit it once and I would have been fine. See? I keep forgetting that. Now that's how I want to deal with that. Strike and then Hadouken. I hear a grub friend. And another plaque. The green children walked from the dream unto these lands. Here we now shall wait, patient, for the call to return. All this deep lore I'm getting. Oh, yep, so that lean knight from earlier was in fact just a regular enemy, so I'm gonna heal up first. I would also like to collect some more soul before fighting him, but there don't seem to be too many other enemies in the area, so I'm not sure if that's an option. And that was just where I came in, so, time for me to get good. Oh wow, I knocked him away quite a bit with that attack. Is that because I hit him during a certain frame of his animation, or is that just a thing that can always occur? Oh, maybe he just jumped away, and it coincided with my attack. Okay, yeah, actually fighting him is not nearly as tough as I thought. In fact, it's actually pretty easy now that I've realized I just need to alternate between top strikes and sideways strikes, which I kind of intuited immediately, but just kind of, I don't know, failed to actually do properly. Oh, nope, you're another knight. Oh, that is a nasty trick. I'm glad I did not drop over to the left first. I kind of screwed up the execution towards the end there, but it went fine overall. I'd like to find a shortcut back to the surface sometime. Oh, these are just going to be knights from now on, aren't they? Ugh. Fail to jump properly. Oh wow, I'm getting wrecked here. Wanna bounce behind them, that's the thing, but if they jump away I don't really have the opportunity. Wow, what? Okay. I thought I had their attack patterns down fine, but I guess not. What? Okay, I died, sure. So let's just recover that all easy-like, and try fighting this knight again. Wait, could I just keep no, if I fail the timing, I end up bouncing late enough that I still end up getting hit by him, yeah. I'm not entirely sure what's happening there. It might be because of him changing his position, like guarding with the shield that causes me to get hit when I try and bounce off. I'm not really sure. Part of the issue is my character's speed and mobility isn't enough to get away if I just screw up the movements at all. Like there, I tried to jump to avoid his horizontal strike, but I just didn't have the speed to do it. Well, whatever. That pain was worth it because I saved another one of my little grub friends. This is probably one of the more, like, fun, collectible things in Metroidvania I've seen. Oh, hello! That's how I gain access to there. Because, like, those little grubs are just so adorable, and when you actually, when you free them and you return to the area where they show up, it's just the cutest thing. Oh. Try that again. There's a lot of stuff in this game that's incredibly cute actually, which is not something I expected too much going in given the overall melancholic tone that the game seems to have, but it's certainly welcome. Ah, so I recognize this sign. That's pointing out an actual proper boss. So I've been told that the difficulty in this game largely comes from how many items you're willing to pick up before fighting a boss. If you just go and challenge the boss immediately, you're gonna have a rough time. But if you take your time and collect all the collectibles that are available before then, you'll have a significantly easier time. Apparently. I couldn't really find that out for myself with the first boss since there weren't really many collectibles prior to it. Oh, that's the bug I found before. Hopefully she's not hostile. Come no closer, ghost. I've seen you creeping through the undergrowth, stalking me. This old kingdom, a terrible thing awakens. I can smell it in the air. I know what you are. I know what you try to do. I can't allow it. Oh, time to fight Hornet. Oh, she had, I just realized that's actually just straight up a threading needle, which is why she was, oh my god, she is awesome. She's using a threading needle like a spear in combination with like a crazy whip because it's a needle and a thread. That is an awesome detail. Okay, thankfully she doesn't go all the way across the screen with that. Oh wait, I don't have any soul to heal up. Oh, I might die here. Yep. Oh wow, they put my corpse a little bit before the boss room. How convenient. Alright, take two. I was supposed to actually attack her during that phase. I was kind of hoping I might be able to talk to her, but nope. Misread what she was gonna do there. Okay, well I thought I was doing good at the start, but now I'm kind of screwing up. Okay, well, I was about to say, wow, I'm managing to get through this without getting hit at all, and then, nope. Here's my time to go for damage. Oh, well not, she just immediately knocks away. I'm not even sure how she hit me there. Ugh, that recovery time after healing. God damn it. You know what I just realized this moment is for? This is when you're supposed to heal. I'm an idiot. Oh, I did not expect it to fly that way. That's the first time she's done that move on the ground. And she's down. Test of resolve. Oh, no, where are you going, my friend? Aw.